Hello children, welcome back to English class. In this video, I am going to narrate the story Gulliver's Travels. I am not reading the story, but I just say the summary of the story. Let's begin. The story name is Gulliver's Travels. The story was written by Jonathan Swift. The story is all about Gulliver, who was a great sailor. This is an autobiography of a sailor. Autobiography means telling about his own life in his own words. It's called autobiography. Let's begin the narration of the story. Gulliver was a sailor who was once caught in land of giants. This is how he describes his experience. His captain had sent all the men to search for water. He got down the boat and went to explore the land, but they could not find any river. As he was turning back, to his surprise, he saw the men or the crew getting into the boat and rowing the boat very fast in order to save their lives before the giant could reach and catch them. So the huge creature was just chasing them. So the giant was unable to catch them. His friends left the place and Gulliver was left alone, and he climbed up a corn plant. He was just hiding on that plant for some time. Soon Gulliver saw that the giant was approaching him nearer, and also there were many giants all around started to reap the crops. Their voice was louder than the trumpet. They were reaping the corn, and suddenly they were all surprised to see such a tiny man. They picked him up in hands and looked with curiosity, and all sat around him and were just admiring him. Gulliver tried to speak with them in several languages as loud as he could, but they could not listen to him. The farmer then took him to his house and placed him on the dining table. Then the dinner was served. The farmer's wife crumbled the bread into pieces and placed before Gulliver. While he was eating, he heard a sound of cat. He had a real adventure there. He saw a big cat and also 1-year-old boy who grabbed him and put his head in his mouth. He shouted very loudly. His mother picked him up immediately and she put him in her bed and covered with a handkerchief. Then Gulliver slept off, dreaming his wife and children. So my students, I hope I am clear to you. Thank you very much.